Hey friends! Welcome to this new tutorial for automating manual tasks. Today, we will discover the Python library PyPDF2 to read PDF files. This series of video is following my article about flashcards, where I explain how you can use flashcards with Anki to improve your journey to language fluency. In this series, I will share with you several tips to create automatically flashcards with vocabulary lists, oral transcriptions, and pictures. Today, we will understand how to use the Python library PyPDF2 to read the content of PDF files to extract text that will feed our vocabulary lists. This vocabulary list will be used to create flashcards. This solution personally helped me when I wanted to study my lessons in the test books. So let's build it. So now we can start. First, we need to import the different libraries, PyPDF2 that you can start using pip, and pandas to manipulate data frame. Again, the same type of visual settings for me to have better visibility on the data frame in the Jupyter notebook. And then we start by opening the PDF report. So the PDF report will be open with this built-in function of Python open. So we are going to take the example of this PDF file. So I've just typed on Google English vocabulary list, and I found this very good document that is coming from Cambridge English. So what is interesting here is that from the page 5, you have a list of vocabulary. The idea today is to build a Python script that will be able to extract these words to feed an Excel file that will be used to create our Ankydex. So you can do the same with English, Italian, French, Chinese. So what I can see here is that the format is quite consistent, except at the end. And we'll see that the main issue that we'll have is to parse, because most of the time you will not be able to extract the tables, because it will depend on the way the PDF file is constructed. But here, let's try to do our best to have the maximum of words and verbs and adverbs to feed our vocabulary list. So back in the Jupyter notebook, so what do we need? First, we need to import PyPDF2 and pandas. PyPDF2 will be used to read the PDF reports, PDF file, and the pandas will be able, we are going to use pandas to export it to Excel file. If you need to install the library, you can use pip. Here, these are visual settings in order to have better visibility of data frames in the Jupyter notebook. And in this part, I'm using the built-in function of Python to open the report and put it in an object. So then the next step is to create a PDF reader object using the library. So let's call it PDF reader. And it will use PyPDF2 and the function PDF file reader. And what we are going to read is the file object. Okay, we're good. The first interesting thing we want is to print the number of pages. So normally we have 56 pages. Yeah, we're good. And then what we are going to do, we are going to create this list, and we loop through all the pages of the document, and I would say we can start from page 6 or page 5 here to n pages. And for each page, we are going to create an object, pdfreader.getPage. So pdfreader, don't forget, is the object that is opening the file. And for in this file, what we want is the page P. And what we are going to do is to append the list with this object, extracted the text. So extract text, yeah, like this. Okay, and then we can run the loop. So what we are going to, so then after we want to have a look at the results. So if I look more, so what we can see here, first we have a lot of line breaks. So line breaks are this backslash n. Sometimes they are separating two words, which is quite good. Sometimes they are in the middle of the word. So for sure here we are going to have a lot of pollution. That means we're not going to recover 100% of the words. We probably need to process it later manually. So before looking at the results, let's just check what kind of tables we have. So we have tables with three columns. For each of the word or group of words, we have the type, if it's a verb or a noun. They are separated with line breaks, and you have the three columns, and at each beginning of subpart we have the letter in capital. We have the year here, the page number, and this presentation. So for sure we are going to extract everything. If we go back to the Jupyter node, what we see after extraction, so we can see here this, the page number, Cambridge English, where is the year, I don't know. What we can see here is the types, but what is a bit annoying is that we have also the line breaks. So here for instance we have angry, line break, adjective, which is good, but here we can see that we have the line break in the middle of the word. So here what you have to know is that it won't be perfect. We will not extract 100% of the words, but what we can do is do our best to do the cleaning automatically, and then after probably we'll need to manually process if we want to retrieve like 100% of the words. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to put the results in the data frame. So here, pages. So here I put the page number, range 1, 2, and text plus 1. And then we put the text. Text, and here, text. I think we're good. Okay. And I want to see the head. Okay, we have the page number, and for each page we have the extract. Then we can perform some processing. So the first processing I want to do is to split the words, is to split the string based on this backslash n that are representing the line breaks. Okay, so output, so we are going to apply, create a new column, split, which equal to, so let me copy the name of the data frame, output, here, so I will apply to text, apply lambda t, and here we are going to use the function split, backslash n, and that should be good. So here what we can see is that we have a backslash and the space. So let's remove also the space. So this will return a list that is supposed to be the number of words, if we suppose that the backslash is separating two words, but we can see here it's not the case. The number of words per page. Let's see how many in total we have at maximum. So here what we can do, we apply to split, point apply. So for each page, we calculate the length of the list associated, so the number of elements. I take the max, print len max, And let's see, output at head. So in maximum we have 163. I think it's she shouldn't be correct. But basically here you can see, so available, oh, it's not bad here actually. Because I use the space, so when we have backlash and inside the word, it's not separating. Oh, it's not that bad actually. Okay. So, then I have an idea. Actually, I have no idea of what I'm doing now, but I'm just trying. So for each column in the range, here we are going, so here what I'm going to do is I'm going to create 163 columns, and are we going to put the n elements in the n columns, and then in each column I'm going to process it and trying to retrieve at the end. So let me just create empty columns, call e equals empty. Then we're good. And then what I'm going to do, I'm going to explode. So here, column one, column two, column three. Okay. So starting from three, split called output.columns, three, boom, split. For all of these columns, what I'm going to do is I'm going to apply at the nth column the nth element, or the case column, the case element. Split dot apply lambda. Apply. So here what I'm going to do is, so for instance, if column is equals 3, I'm going to look at all the elements of the list. If the element is the third element, I'm going to put it in the column 3. So for this I'm going to loop. And what I'm going to check first, so I'm going to return nothing if the list, if the length of the list is below the column number plus one, yeah, because it started from zero. So for instance, if the list has five elements and here we have at the column seven, I will return nothing because there is not seven element. Else I will return the eighth element of the list, and I will replace, you remember this backslash and thing inside the word, I will replace them with empty value. Okay, and then I will return output just the head. So here it will be an initial cleaning. Of course I don't think it's going to be perfect, but at least we can have a slight vision of what it is returning. So if I come back here, so you see it looks like good actually. Here I think we missed the type that is here now. It's okay, they check the hotel. Yeah, it start to become a bit clearer. What can I do next? But honestly, not that much now. I think it's enough for this video. Probably we can do that later in a more deep NLP tutorial. But now to introduce PyPDF2, I think it's quite enough. So to sum up, you can open any PDF report, extract the text, put it in a list, and then it's the beginning of the happiness where you have to perform some cleaning. I hope it was clear enough. If you have any question, feel free to let them in the comment section. Thank you.